Hey, you guys. Hope everybody is doing good. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. He's so good, you guys. How is everybody? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. How are you this evening? Thank you, Lord. God is so good. He's beautiful. Face to face. Good evening, you guys. I see Australia peeps on here. I see American people. Awesome and wonderful. Ooh. Wednesday evening, 9 p.m. Eastern. Apostle Don Hughes and I are going to be going live. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, Tiffany. Hey, you guys. His love, his grace is pouring down the mountain of all my mistakes. Come on. Who needs that? I do. I need it. You can suggest a song, Patrick. I've never done that before, but you can. Why not? I've got another one after this, and then why not? Come on, this is our time together. There's no agenda. I don't exactly have a scripture verse or anything. You know? Woo! Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Face to face. I want to see the Lord face to face, you guys. Come on. He's leading you. I'm so desperate for God, and I speak that desperation over you all. Nothing can pull you from God. Nothing can pull you out of his hands. Nothing. Woo! I want that special time with the Lord. Come on. I want to dive into his heart, to dive into the pool of shalom that he is. He's health, wholeness, and healing. Oh, and I want to be submersed in that. Oh, God in heaven, we thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That was Face to Face by Matt Kearney. And this is Show Me by Becca Shea. Show us, Lord. Come on, we need that mercy. We need mountains of it. We need a river of it. Thank you, Jesus. Lord. Ha! He's consuming what's trying to consume you, unless it's him. Woo! Jesus, we thank you. You're welcome here. Your angels are welcome here. You've got questions? God can take it. The world of mystery, and he's ready to reveal it to you. He's ready to show you. Woo! Show us, Lord. Illuminate the truth to me, God. Show me the truth, Lord. Woo! Signs, symbols. God's speaking to you. All those numbers you keep seeing in sequence. Come on. Miss Sharon Jordan. Hey, blessings. Charlie Ray Jordan's wife. Hey, y'all. Come on. Woo! You can get as wild and as crazy in Jesus as you want. You can have as much of him as you want. But he loves you enough to even let you have none of him, if that's what you want. I don't want none of him. I want all of him. And you know what? If that makes people hate me, if that makes people malign me, if that makes people jealous, come on. Maybe they'll get jealous and get saved. Jesus, you're beautiful. Come on, illuminate the truth to me. With no deception here. Show us, Lord. Show us, Lord. I'm going to pray. I'm going to play this one a second time. Come on, we're going to seek until we find him. Somebody, you're right at the edge. You're at that veil. You're ripping and tearing through the veil. It's the resistance you hit. It's not the devil. It's the glory. You hit the resistance that you're feeling. It's the glory of God. Press into it. It's not the enemy keeping you out. It's God saying, do you feel me? That weightiness, that heaviness. It's me. Press into me. I'm here if you'll just want it. How bad do you want it? Woo! Oh, Jesus, we thank you. I'm going to do this one more time. God is willing to show you his mysteries. He's willing to show you his treasures. Some of you feel like you just don't belong. Do you feel like you don't belong? Oh my goodness. Do you know what it is to feel like you don't belong? To feel like no one loves you, no one wants you, that you have nobody? It's a lie. It's a lie of the enemy. He's a crazy lying devil. You're wanted. You're loved. You're cared about. You're not alone. There's a host. Legions upon legions of angels are with you. There are people praying for you you don't even know about. You never even heard their names. They're praying for you. God put you on their heart. It's a world of mystery. He's unveiling it. The glory of God is piercing through deception. You're going to walk away from this video tonight being able to see greater than you've ever seen before. You thought you knew the devil's voice. You thought you knew the Lord's voice. But tonight you won't be going, was that you, God? You'll know. Thank you, Jesus. Whatever devil has held you, there have been those who have been in a spirit of depression. We rebuke that thing now in Jesus' name. We pull the rug out from underneath its feet. We send it back to where it came from. Where are all your questions? Ask the Lord and expect him to answer. He's a good, good daddy. My daddy answers my questions. He doesn't love me more than he loves you. Ha! Seek him for it. He will show you and tell you great and mighty things you've been wanting to know. He hid it for you so the devil couldn't find it. I'm crazy enough. Come on. I remember telling somebody one time. They said, you can't do that. And I said, you know what? I don't care. God tells me to put on a clown nose, dye my hair blue, and go out into the street with a transfer truck coming down the road and turn upside down on my head. I'm crazy enough to believe the truck will stop, vanish, or bypass me or go right through me. And no harm. Come on. What has God asked you to do in this season? Might seem crazy, might seem wild, might make you look weird to other people. They might decide to hate you. Come on, they might decide you're their best friend. Maybe you need some new friends. Come on. Come on. Come on. What was somebody wanted to give me a song request? What kind of request you got going on here? How many miles must it take to break through that resistance? It's not the resistance of the devil that you're facing. It is God himself, and he's not resisting you, but you're at the veil. Push through. Push. The waters have ruptured. They're breaking. You feel the pressure as the baby's head is descending. Come on, you feel it. You can feel. I feel your thunder pouring like rain down on the mountains. There's really, this is the thing, there's exposure that comes when the bride births. Hear me. When the bride births, she can't give birth to the child with pants on, with her skirt tied between her legs or down. Come on, the skirt's got to be lifted up. The bride of Christ is birthing. That's all of us. God is exposing hearts privately in prayer chambers if we let him. The baby, the child has to come out or it will die. Push. Push through the veil. Push into the arms of Jesus. Fathers, I'm telling you, Father is watching on as Jesus is, he's holding you in his arms. You've got the baby in your arms. I want to tell somebody this. I just saw you with Jesus. The baby's in your arms. You're holding it, and Jesus has his arms wrapped around you. You're holding the baby. Holy Spirit took the baby when you birthed it. As the waters gushed out, he carried the baby and placed it up into your arms. You didn't lose it. It wasn't aborted. It wasn't stolen. Come on. Your purpose has not been waylaid. The angels have not left you. God has not forsaken you. It is lies from the devil that you're hearing that's contrarywise to the things of God. We take authority over any voice, word, anything that contradicts this word right here. We command it to shut its mouth. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And you know what? I hope that encouraged somebody. You're seeing the Lord face to face right now. And some of you go, but I'm not a seer. I don't know what you're talking about. You can feel his presence. He just answered your prayer request. He just gave you. You got the breakthrough in the such and such. That's seeing him. Come on, it's seeing him right there in your face with the miracle. That's pursuing and overtaking you because you're pursuing him. And I want to tell Patrick, I don't really know you on a personal level in any way, shape, or form. But I do want to say this, Patrick. The Lord was showing me that people who hate you, and this word is for anyone else on here, that you feel it leap like your baby leap in your belly. You just know, oh, that's for me. Like you and God were talking about this. God is causing those who hate you to get on their knees. And repentance is coming. They're going to say they're sorry. Woo! The fire of God has gone out. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And I want to tell somebody on here right now. And this is the wildest thing. I just saw three names, three people back to back to back. And I'm like, well, that's wild. I'll just call it out. Cheryl, TD, Aspen, Pamela. Pam, I want to say this. You do not need to go apologize to a dangerous person. If they are dangerous, you don't go and apologize to them. You don't go disrespect them. You don't go to somebody who is mocking you, raving at you, and acting like a lunatic or a maniac. You let them continue on their way acting like a lunatic or a maniac. And let God deal with it. And Anima, you're on here. Thank you, Jesus. You're standing in front of a wall, and it's like a dark slate blue color. Not dark blue, but a slate blue. I'm not sure if you know what color that is, but it's that color has oftentimes reminded me of Holy Spirit. But God is coming in, and he's painted that blue because it had a little bit of depression in it. He's painted it this beautiful yellow color. He's causing what was dark in your life. And it was at the background. It wasn't really in the forefront. It was like off somewhere. He's taking and painting it out of the picture. He's undoing it, reversing it, rolling it out of the picture, out of the home, out of the house, out of your life, away and out of your hands. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my goodness. Melissa, I see you on here, darling. I want to say this. I saw you with long hair, and I saw each little piece of your hair, almost like, you know, a little portion, about like this. And it was done up like this. Rolled up, and inside there was these big old, you know, those old-fashioned big old fat pink roller things in there. And so I saw that in there in your hair, and I'm like, Lord, what is this? Why am I seeing that? And the Lord says he is causing your strength to be renewed in this season. He's strengthening you, but he's also making you to the point that where people are looking at you, his assignment that he has on your life, they're looking from the outside in going, she's weird, she's strange, she's peculiar, she's odd, look at her, the way she's doing this, the way she's doing that, that's weird. And God says he made you that way on purpose so that the right people will find you, so the right people who will respond to your sound will come. They can receive from you. You're out in the market. You're in the whatever. Come on. You're saying some of these people, I really feel like who have, mocking isn't quite the right word for it, but at any rate, the judgmentalness, it's family members. It's family. Okay. But keep doing what you're doing. That's really what I'm hearing from the Lord, is just to keep doing what it is you're doing. You're not doing anything wrong. Thank you, Jesus. Good and pull me away. In this season, I will tell you what the devil is doing. As we're fixing to go into 5780, we're in 5779, the Jewish year of 5779. We're going into 5780. As we enter into 5780, we're being tried, we're being tested, and the devil is looking for an en route. He's looking to find the one thing he can take you down with. He's looking for the one thing he can get you to compromise with. He wants you, as you're heading for the new, to be derailed, to fall off, to slide off. He wants you to not be humble. He wants you to take up an offense. Come on, whatever it is, he really doesn't care. If he can just waylay you before you get to the entry level, the entry point, if he can just waylay you before you walk through the door, he doesn't care. What he uses against you to waylay you. Come on. He doesn't care what he gets you to believe about others or yourself. if you'll just compromise. But the one thing that I keep seeing, he's trying to find something that's in your hands you don't want to let go of. That if you lost it, you'd be in a panic. Or if you lost it, you'd be lost. Acknowledge that. Take that to the Lord. When God shows you what that is, take it to the Lord and confess it. I confess, Lord, that if I lost such and such, I would feel like I was lost. I would feel like I was defeated. I would feel like I'm a nobody. I would feel like, fill in the blank, whatever that is. Because that way you've exposed that thing and the devil cannot use it against you. Although I cannot say what. Or at least I don't think I can. It's not that I don't know what. I'm just saying some things you just don't talk about. He's looking for that one thing. Come on. Don't let the devil have the upper hand. Don't let him get you offended. Don't let him take from you. Jonathan, I see you breathing fire out of your mouth. I also see you in a vehicle, and it's almost like red. It looks like a Batmobile, sort of. And, you know, it's like a stealth riding thing with the wind of the Lord. And I see it breathing fire out. Like, it's got these big engine jets on the side of it, and it's breathing this fire out. And you're taking down the enemy as you're doing it. You're actually making a greater impact than you even think you are. You have no clue to the amount or the impact that you are doing. Sometimes you think you do, but you don't. I'm just telling you, God is pleased. Now, there are some people, I honestly believe that there are people that have told you that the things that you're doing are not appropriate and even demonic. But I'm telling you right now, God says that what you're doing is appropriate, and he is very, very happy with what you're doing. You're making an exceedingly great impact with that flame and that fire. And it's a fast vehicle. I'm telling you, it's riding fast, fast, very fast in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord God, we just thank you. We thank you. We praise you. We worship you. You're holy. You're mighty. So, Jonathan, that was for you, darling. That was for you. I see Susan on here. And I just want to say with regards to you, Susan. This is the wildest thing. He's got you dressed up like Supergirl. I mean, you're dressed up like Supergirl in the realm of the spirit. I'm seeing that. The Lord is showing me that. And it was almost like people tried to mention or say something, or almost like they didn't outright say it. It was like they tried to imply as though you're, oh good, Jonathan, I'm glad that was confirmation for you. It's almost like people tried to imply your clothing was soiled or a different color or something about you was contrary wise to what you know to be the truth. But Susan, I just want to tell you what I'm seeing is it's white. The mantle is white and it's outlined, dipped in and drawn along the edges with the blood of Jesus. I'm just telling you. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we thank you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, we thank you. I wonder what that is. This is my little computer stand right here squeaking. I got my arm on it. Every time I touch it, it squeaks. The chair's squeaking. Between all of that, it's... Anyway. Thank you, Jesus. And Susan, he's got you outfitted to run fast. He's got you running, and I see a lot more traveling. Traveling. Running. Quick stuff. It's almost like it's going to be, I think it's almost going to be like, go out, do something quick and come back, like short runs, but it's running, it's going out. It's quick. And the shoes you have on, it's wild because they're tennis shoes and they're white, but they're platforms. And I mean, they're platforms. They're like dressy tennis shoes and they got sparkle going on them. I'm just telling you, these are like every girl's dream, at least, you know, for me, for having sparkly things. Oh my goodness, he's talking to me about this. This is really opening up for with regards to Susan. The diamonds that I'm seeing along the outer edge of the platform shoes, all the way around the edges, that I was just thinking about, and I was asking the Lord, well, Lord, what do you think that's about? What is that for? Why are you showing? I mean, the diamonds. Diamonds are built with pressure. Come on, they are made due to pressure. They are birthed in pressing environments, and you have been pressed on all sides in just the right places. I want to say that right now. God has pressed you on all sides in just the right places. And this is character. Come on. These diamonds are character. It's character that has been birthed in the heights, in the high places, in the seasons of the quiet times, in the presence, in the treasuries of the Lord. Come on. You've been up in the private chambers with the Lord. You've been doing what God's asked you to do. Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Jehu. I see Jehu. I see you with a pack of dogs. It's like you're hunting. God has you hunting. And you've got them all, and they're kind of, you know, you're trying to pull them back some, but they're trying to run up ahead of you. And these dogs, they're hot on the trail of the enemy. Oh! And when you get close enough to the enemy, I tell you this, the Lord will have you unleash those dogs. It's like I see people with you. You're going to be, it's like they're trained, they're equipped, they're ready, but you're holding them back because they can't come out the barn yet. And as soon as you get to where you're going, it's like God will tell you, turn them loose, and you will loose them, and they will go. They will go. But here's the thing, you might think, wait a minute, they got leashes on. And you say, loose them. What about the leash dragging on the ground? That is so in case they get into trouble, you can just reach out supernaturally and pull them back up and in. Come on. Come on. It's a type of spiritual parentage. Come on, you're working with the Lord. Come on. But they're going after Jezebel. They're going after what came after. It's almost like they're going after what came after people in the community. Hey, Martha. Whew. And so you're taking on what's in the community, but you're not doing it by yourself. You're doing it in a group. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And I want to say this, because I don't always see, well, I'm going to say in the past, quite like this, but you have your own. You have your own ministry. You have your own. I know them a little bit on a personal level, so I'm trying not to think of anything. You know, I'm just like, I'm trying to stay to all the spiritual stuff, the aspects of it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It's corporate intercession and through the equipping and training of saints. And y'all pulling down what's in your region, what's in your territory. And I believe that's why you were in times past hit so hard. You didn't know who you were in the beginning. But the devil saw you in seed form and said, I have seen that kind before. Oh, I have seen that kind before. Oh, I have seen that kind before. Come on, that's apple seed. That's a corn seed. Oh, I know what that grows into. We're going to have to do something. That'll be a mighty oak tree one day. So we got to take it out in its infancy. Oh! But the devil can't take you out. He's not going to take you out. In the name of Jesus. I want to speak that over everybody that's on this video right now. You are untakeoutable. I know that's not proper English. You are untakeoutable. He cannot take you out. Huh, come on. The devil can't take you out. Thank you, Jesus. Whoever's doing the angry faces, I don't know what you're doing the angry faces for. If you don't want to be on here, leave the video. You can just leave. We're fine if you go. We won't hate you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Linda, I do want to say this. I see you with snow all over the ground. You put on there, you know, Alaska or whatever. If it doesn't say Alaska, then that's what I'm reading it to say, because I must be either in the natural or by the spirit. I'm seeing Alaska. But I'm seeing white blanket. There's just this huge white blanket of snow, and it's so deep, it's way over your head. But God has caused you to transform when, as you pray, as you are interceding, as you are loving on the Lord, as you are overflowing and erupting. As you're overflowing and erupting. If anybody knows who the frowny face person is, the angry face, and can get them off of here, let me know so I can block them. Let me. I don't mind blocking them. We love them. We love you. We love you. You're blessed. You're so blessed, baby. You're so blessed. You're so blessed. But I see the river and the love of God. He's causing you to transform all that snow. He's causing, I'm seeing the sunlight where you are. And it begins to, you begin to get a little barrier, like a little break between you and the snow. But it keeps growing and growing as the heat, the glory in you begins to grow. Come on, it begins to, and the snow is fought back. The snow is melted. It's caused to be deceased. You're transforming the environment with your mouth and your words. You're transforming. Creation has been waiting on you, Linda. Creation has been waiting on you. When you open your mouth, the sound in your mouth is causing creation to be transformed. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Creation is being transformed. The angels are picking up your words and running with them. Oh, the angels are picking up your words and running with them. I'm seeing Jesus smiling, and Father God is going like this. He's going, mm. Father God is going, mm. Almost like when you see your child, they've already finished and crossed the line. They've already crossed. Come on, they've already crossed the finish line. Thank you. Thank you, Melissa. Thank you. We'll find out who it is. Jesus already knows. He'll give us a name. You know how that is. And we'll block them. We love them. But we can love you at a distance. Loving people at a distance is A-okay. That's called boundaries. That makes you a clean river, a pure stream. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we just thank you right now. Tara. I may not be saying your name right. Tara. It's a beautiful name. But I keep hearing the word mattress, and I keep seeing springs all in this mattress. Okay, it's about like this deep, and it's like a queen size mattress. So hear me. I'm picking all these words out of this vision. You're a queen in the kingdom, Tara. You're a queen in the kingdom. Come on. God has filled this mattress so full of springs that he can springboard you anywhere. You are able in any environment, no matter where you are, no matter where you're at, you're able to leap up into the glory realms, to leap up into the high places, and the enemy can't stop you because the springs are in place. You're a queen on this mattress, and you can spring into action at any environment. God has had you in environments where you were like, do you hate me, Lord? Are you hating me? No, he does not hate you. He loves you. He knew when he put you there, he said, Tara can transform it. Come on. Tara can transform that environment. Ooh. Ooh. Who wants to be the one to transform hell? That's all around, you know? I'm not saying where you are right now is hell all around by any means, okay? But what I am saying is that God knew when he's put you there, you could transform it. He knew you wouldn't give up. He knew you wouldn't give in. He knew you would not sit down. He knew it. And I see two Taras on here. I want you both to receive that. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Some people don't like others getting loved on. But one day, this is a prophetic word for the frowny face person, the angry face person. One day when you won't love, how you've been restricting people is not. Thank you so much for commenting. I knew if I loved on you,
you'd comment. You blocked, baby, you blocked. I wish he could have heard that word, but God, this basically what this word is, it's that God is not going in his time of need. Well, there's another frowny face. That's all right. You know, God is not in their time of need going to do to them what they've done to others. I can tell you that now. So we bless you, we love you, we care about you, and God is having his way even in your life. He's transforming you, and he's filling you from the inside out. Come on. God loves you. Amen, Beth. Stop the mad face, try smiling. Come on. When my son died, God said, put a smile on your face. Maria, I did. I blocked him. I blocked him, honey. I blocked him, baby. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Tiffany Love Smith, I'm looking at your name, and that love, I keep seeing the word love right in the middle. Love, love, love. God kept telling me that 5780 is going to be everyone's best year yet. But he kept saying it was for what? For what purpose and for what reason? So that when others look at us, it's a season of love. It's for lovers to find each other, to marry and form kingdom marriages, both spiritually and naturally. But it's also a time for us to love on others and Christians, as well as we're supposed to be especially good to those in the brotherhood, so we're told. Especially good to for other Christians. But even strangers, we're to love on them so much so that the world knows that's a true Christian. That's a real Christian. And how are they going to know that? The Bible says because we don't forsake loving each other. By our love, they can tell that we are of God. By the way we respond, by the way we love and don't hate. By the way we don't bring accusations. Come on. Now, there are times to talk about stuff and you have to make a claim. You have to lay a claim and say, this is something that needs talked about. My goodness, it's not an accusation if it's the truth. Some things just have to be talked about. But I'm talking about getting up and reviling and, you know, Anyway, I saw your middle name Love, honey. That middle name Love. And God says that's who you are. That's his heart and that his heart is in you. And you are loving on others around you and transforming them. You are transforming them. This is the first week. We are only halfway into the first week of the school. Somebody sign up for that if you want. Private message me later for the university. Shannon, Evangelist St. Shannon, I want to pray for you right now. You oftentimes send me messages and I can't read all of it, you know, because I'm very busy. But I want to take this time right now corporately to pray for you. We just speak love over you. We speak a blessing over you. We just thank the Lord that he's wrapped his blanket of love all around you, and that all of your needs are met, that a quick maturity, I'm seeing a quick maturity, a fire being lit under you and in you, and God is maturing, transforming, and rearranging you right now from the inside out in the name of Jesus. His love is pouring down on you. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Transformed by love. Whew. Alex, I just saw a picture. Now, Holy Spirit, help me with this one. You were holding a briefcase and you were whacking. You were whacking things with that briefcase. And it's like a business. It's business mantle, business anointing, the business mountain. And, oh, I like that. At first, I thought, my Lord, I think he's whacking people on top of the head, and that's demonic. We need to tell you to stop, but that's not what... I was looking closer, and I said, what is he whacking on top of the head? Are these people? Don't make me rebuke this person on a live stream, but it's not. It's like you're in this business world, and you are literally your briefcase, the business plans, the strategies that God has given to you, you are beating devils down with it. You are literally, these are strategies from heaven, and you are using that briefcase, that business mantle, that business anointing. And if you don't have a business, you need to ask the Lord and start one, because I see the briefcase in your hand, and you are whacking those devils right up on the head with that briefcase. Ha! Ha! And you've got two of the briefcases, and you are just going at it, and you are, what you are doing, you are a forerunner in the business realm that God has you in, and God has you blazing a trail, whacking these devils out of the way on the business mountain. As you head up that mountain, other people are coming up behind you. Other people are coming up behind you. God has other people coming up behind you. And if you were not being obedient, if you didn't do what it is God asked you to do, and it has not been easy, but because you have been obedient and you're doing this, the people coming up behind you, even family members, are able to now walk in freedom and build and to do. You've had to war and build at the same time. They get to build with almost no war. Come on. You've had to war and to build, but they get to build with almost no warfare. Come on. Bill even said that. That resonated with him. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Alex said hallelujah. You know what? That sacrifice. I just keep hearing the word sacrifice. You made so many sacrifices, and those sacrifices have all been worth it. They have 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 been worth it. You counted the cost. And at times we, you know, don't let the devil do that to you. You know, sometimes, you know, you look at the cost and you go, oh my gosh. Did I make a misstep? Am I supposed to be going this way? You know, did I miss the Lord? Did it have to be this hard? Maybe I did it, took a wrong turn. Maybe I did something. But no, sometimes it looks like it costs us more than the outcome, but it's not, because when you look behind at the trail that you've blazed and the people that are coming up behind you, it has all been worth it. You're getting them across the finish line. They couldn't have gone across the finish line if you had not waged war with the devil, had you not come into that arena and made it easier for them. Oh, they'd have been lost and left behind. Come on. Come on. Amen, Dorina. Amen, Dorina. Beautiful woman of God. Blessings. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Legacy, amen. And Dorina, because I don't know about y'all's children or anything like that, but I see you heavy pregnant. And some of this could be all related spiritually, but, you know, I'm just going to give the word. I see three children in tow, meaning your three children already out. And you're heavy pregnant. And spiritually, you have this sword in your hand. I see you riding in a car, and the children are walking beside you because the car's going slow. Prophet John Dalen Coleman, blessings, sir. Mighty man of God, y'all need to follow him and get his latest book. It's all about prophets and the prophetic. I had the privilege, awesome privilege, of getting to read that book prior to it coming out. And I'm telling you, the character transformation, even in my own personal life, that is something you need to get into. But Dorina, as I saw you in there, you had that sword and you were protecting the pregnancy. You're protecting what God's entrusted you with. You're protecting the children. Come on. You're protecting it. You know how to use the word. You know how to use it. You know how to use it. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. Your children are blessed to have you. They're blessed. They're blessed. Thank you, Jesus. Celeste, we just pray for you right now. Blessings, Prophet John. We just pray for you right now, Celeste, that you, God will give you that download, that strategy. You'll get to where he has for you, because God has not abandoned you. And he has a purpose and a place for you. He has a purpose and a place for you. Purpose and a place for you. Jesus. Janae. I'm looking at you, and I was asking the Lord about you, and I saw this crown. It's gold laid upon your head. And then Jesus said, I love her so much Now get this. He says, I love her so much. When she looks at life, she sees the good stuff. And I rarely let her see all the bad in people. She looks and she's always got like seeing the best in stuff. And he said, because I saw he came along. Jesus plucked flowers with his own hands. Woo! I received that, Prophet John. That word hit me. Glowing and growing, Prophet. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Blessings, sir. I saw Jesus with his own hands. Have you ever taken a flower and then tied another flower to it and another flower and you made a string? Multiple strands and strings of flowers all in front of your face. And so when I saw that, I said, Lord, why are the flowers blocking her view? How can she see? He said, no, all she sees is the beauty. All she sees is the pretty stuff. That's what I let her see. I've authored her that way on purpose. She encourages other people who want to be downtrodden, who want to be depressed, who want to see the evil. You're a gift in the body of Christ, honey. You're a gift in the body of Christ. And that's amazing, because I feel like the Lord said you stood still enough in his presence for him to do that. Because you can't be running around like a mad maniac and Jesus tie these things and make them. It took time. Time. You spent time in the presence of the Lord. You were still in his presence. You were still in his arms. You were still at his bosom. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's so pleased with you. 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 Amen. Thank you, Lillian. Blessings, blessings. Hey, Elena. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, Vincent. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my goodness, Elena. Elena, I'm having a vision about you right now. This is the most wildest thing. Elena. I know it's an account y'all share, but this is for Elena. Jared and Elena, but it's for Elena. I'm seeing you on, it looks like you're in a bowl. Or, okay, not even that. Have you seen those little things like, you know, the stoves that are not flat top that have the little spiral ring things that plug in? They heat up. You put your pot on it, you know. Not that part, but the part underneath that they can be silver or black, but these are black. You know, that part that's the drip pan that catches anything that spills over in the oven. You're in one of those in a great ocean. I know that's crazy, but you're in one of those in a great ocean. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Somebody just took down a thing spiritually. Thank y'all. I appreciate that. And so You've God put this, what looks like, there's this cartoon character. I don't remember his name, but it was a big bear. And evidently it was like a rain hat, and it kind of came out like this and kind of came like this. And it's kind of elongated in the front. Why? Because you are facing the wind and the rain of God, and you are going fast in this thing. It's like you're in this drip pan, but it doesn't have a hole in the bottom. That's what the boat looks like. And you are holding on to the sides of it, and the motor is the wind of God. The motor is the spirit of the living God. And he has you zooming, 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 zooming. And you're going so rapidly and so much on fire with this. And you are actually atop. You are riding on top of the tsunami of God. You are seeing firsthand as it crashes into demonic structures as well as blessings, especially this part, as well as blessing others around you. I am seeing you get a firsthand glimpse at people being blessed. Whew. Thank you, Jesus. 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 5780. It's the new beginnings. You have been graced to perfection to begin again into the multiplication. And it's like the zero there. God keeps saying not only is that multiplication anointing, but it's also an indefinite, like innumerable. It's don't limit God. He's limitless in 5780. He's the limitless God. You're going to see him do things to an extent that not only will it astound you and astound others, but it will astound y'all to an extent that you actually have to pause, stop, and go, how's that even possible? It's that good and it's that widespread across the body of Christ. I'm telling you, you're graced. Five can mean grace and it can mean death. Death to the demonic that held you. The demonic hands had to loose you and let you go. Ha, come on. The angels are between you and every demonic thing right now. You're graced to perfection. The seven is spiritual perfection. The eight, we call it new beginnings, but it actually can mean something else. The end of the old, the death of the thing in the past. The past shut down. Something stopping and ending and being over. You're going into the unexpected. And that's that zero. You're going into the greatness, the goodness, and the abounding multiplication of God to an extreme that the body of Christ has just not seen. Woo! Lord Jesus, we just praise you. Blessed you are if people revile you, accuse you, and call you all manner of things that you are not. That's scripture. If you follow Christ, you will be persecuted. If you follow Christ, you will drink from the same cup. But if you are persecuted, the word says, in this age, in this life, not just when you get to heaven, in this age, in this life, you will receive 100-fold what the devil stole. Did he take your house? Did he take your children? Did he take your spouse? Did he take your mom, your dad? What did he take? Houses, fortunes, 100-fold, 100-fold. Come on. Marianne, I'm looking at that thinking triplets. I'm looking at that thinking the quadruple, which is four. Over and over and over. I'm looking at that and seeing eight new beginnings with the quadruple. I'm looking at that number 444 and seeing 12. That's reigning and ruling. Come on, that's being in leadership. You get to determine if you're going to reign and rule and lead, if you're going to lag behind. You don't need anybody's permission to reign and rule. I went through a phase, oh my gosh, y'all, this was like probably 20 years ago, 15, 20 years ago. I don't know, it's been a while. I had to turn in all my prophetic words. 7 years of it, almost 7 years anyway, of turning in all my prophetic words. Well, I have been out of that season a very long time. And now, other prophets and people, you know, people know that when I speak, you know, it's accurate. And now it's judged more, you know, a mutual judging as we all write and do. And recently somebody was just like, well, you need to start turning stuff in and submitting it before you just put that out there. And I'm like, honey, I done passed that season a long time ago. I don't need your permission to do what it is I'm doing. I don't need your permission to go as you, to be the go-between between me and Facebook land, or me and the Lord, or me and whatever. So I want to say to somebody right now, you do not need somebody else's permission to reign and rule, to do what God has told you to do. Just go and do it. That's how come the people who've never been in church and they're not religious, they will oftentimes be some of the most obedient people, because they don't know what it is to hear a voice that says, oh, don't do this. Oh, don't do that. Oh, that might be the devil. Oh, they just know God's voice and they heard him say a thing and they go and do it. They may not even know this, but they know God's voice and they go and do it. They don't need to go, I need 50 scriptures to back that up. I need 25 people to come and talk to me and shake my hand and give me a prophetic word. And then I need some gift to come in the mail. And let's go put a bucket outside and see if it gets 8 inches of water in it. And then I want to see if the deer or some antelope from Africa walks across my yard out in Tennessee before I go and do. They don't do that. They hear God's voice and they go and do it. So I just want to bless y'all with a release right now. You can hear God's voice. You are obedient. And you actually go and do what it is God has asked you to do. Woo! Come on. That's true. I do like what Celeste said here. Seasons change. Some don't understand that. They will actually judge you by their season, by whatever season they're in. Come on. Come on. I get that a lot, you know, the prayer house and different things that I do, the university, I will have people, you know, say things to me like, well, where's your husband? Are your kids grown? Where's your husband? Come on. I don't know when he's coming. Come on. I don't know when. But I'm not going to sit down on my butt and do nothing. And, you know, in the waiting process. Come on. I like that, Pastor Robert. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Well, I feel like I'm going to get off of here. My hands are on fire. I want to release right now an anointing on your life. Please let me know if you feel the anointing on this live stream. I want to release to those who are having shoulder issues. I want to release to those who are having sin addictions. You know what you're, you know, I'm not even going to name the addiction to the different sins that you have. You can feel it right now. So this healing that's in my hands that I'm releasing right now over the live stream. This is for in your body. It's for your mind. It's your will, your emotions. Come on, whatever it is. It's for sin. Whatever healing you need right now to receive from the Lord, let the fire of God, whoo, let it hit your house now. Let you be transformed. And I just command angels right now. Hey, Jamaica, darling. Let the angels of God surround your home. You will sleep well. You will not be inhibited from having great, wonderful, glory encounters with the Lord. May you go into heaven this evening in glorious places to bring back whatever word God has for you, whatever beautiful encounter you can have with the bridegroom. Come on, Jesus is waiting for you to encounter him in your dreams, in your visions, spiritually. Come on. Because what you gain in that experience is so real, you can hand it out to others, and they can grasp hold of. Come on. Hey, Kathy. Do me a favor and share this video. I don't even know how I even got this many viewers on the live stream tonight because I was put in Facebook jail. This morning, in the middle of the night, really, early morning, I made a post, and then I said I'm going to share the post into my group, Prophetic Pools, my own group. I shared the post into my own group. I immediately got a notification. You have been banned from certain functions regarding groups for inappropriate posting in groups. And I'm like, I thought, well, maybe I hit the wrong group. I looked. No, it went exactly where I wanted it to go. I thought, I'll check on that in a minute. I don't know what they're talking about. So then I tried to share another post of mine I had posted. Same thing. I get another notification. You have, now certain functions are not going to work for you in groups. You have violated community standards. It's like, it says you can only share in groups you moderate or own. And I'm like, this is my own group. What's wrong with you? So anyway, that has been a fun thing. So I'm really shocked that we had so many on here with us tonight. Thank y'all for jumping on. I love you. I love you. I love you. Y'all are such a blessing. Amen. We take authority over fear. Come on. And control. Amen, Linda. How does your shoulder feel? Is it feeling better, darling? Amen, Bill. He's pouring out his spirit. The Lord increase you 1,000 times. I'm just praying this for Vincent. The Lord increase you 1,000 times.
Courts of heaven, this is what I want to say. Oh, excuse me.
I had like 45 minutes of sleep or 1 hour and 15 minutes sleep in the past like 48 hours. That's been fun. I don't even know how I look okay and normal. I look at myself in the eyes and go, I don't even look like I'm sleepy. God must have done something supernatural. But Vincent, what I'm seeing is something in the past. And so we take that to the courts right now. Whatever is preventing your finances, we come into agreement right now. Whatever those things were, sinful things, seeing stuff in the bloodline, we put the blood of Jesus on that. The blood of Jesus and the name of Jesus speaks louder than any of that. And so, Father God, we thank you right now that you bless him with your great mercy, grace, and love. Oh, that's sweet, Norma. Thank you so much. She says, I look fabulous. Woo! I think it's the lighting. It's the low lighting in the room. I'm like, should I get closer? Can you see? Do I look okay? But I keep seeing 1,000 times greater. I do. Y'all, please message me. Get in the university. We have scholarships available to where you're not going to have to pay anything. Anytime we have scholarship monies available until it runs out, I'm saying as long as you meet the requirements and you're not like a Satanist. You know, if you were and you repent, well, you can come on board. But I'm just saying, in order to be in the school, you need to be a Christian. You need to agree that, you know, definitely like there's nothing wrong with the prophetic, because if you're not okay with that, this wouldn't be the school for you. It's for prophetic people, especially people who can see. Oh, Norma, that's so sweet. Monica, that is so sweet. I'm getting off of here. Y'all gonna make me weep and cry. Cheryl, I love you. I'm just saying, oh, y'all my besties. Y'all my besties. What are the requirements, Jehu? Private message me about the requirements. Tonight, the only requirements, because we have the scholarship funds available, is you have to be a Christian. You have to be a Christian. We actually pulled a student out of level, that we pulled two out of level one, and one of them was most definitely not a Christian. And I don't mind him being on my public lives, but he cannot be in the class group. It's an unsaved Iranian, and we picked up so much warfare, and it's like, oh my goodness, we're going to love you in the public live streams. The university is really not the place for you, darling. Okay. Oh, where do we sign? Where do you sign up? Private message me in the messenger. Send me a private message. I will send you that information. It's an easy, simple process. So, I love you guys. We have 8 different types of classes too. Oh my gosh. We have, what do we have? Level ones, basic prophetic. It's all over the place. I mean, you're going to learn a little bit about everything. All kinds of stuff. You're going to be like, oh my gosh, I didn't know this. I didn't know that. Oh my gosh. Oh, well, I knew some of that. I knew some of that. Oh, I didn't know that. You know, courts of heaven stuff, all kinds of different things, colors, numbers, dreams, visions, spiritual gifts. Does, you know, operate the way God designed you to operate. Level two is your identity. And it's based on a lot of word pictures that people who have dreams and visions and seers would have. But the Bible as well. Level three is Israel. What do we got to do with Israel? Level four is demonology, deliverance, counseling, and Father's heart. Level five is evangelism. You don't have to take them in order. Just take whatever, which ones you need, want, or take them in order. If you want to be ordained, most people go in order. If you want to be licensed, they usually take at least the first 4 levels, you know, to be licensed or ordained. And, but anyway, level 5 is evangelism. Level 6 is publish your story. There's 3 different ways we teach you how to publish your own story. And there's different costs, anywhere from free all the way up the ladder, you know. And then, Finances. I have a paid for house in ministry. So there's financial freedom out there. There's a financial teachings. Come on. And level 8 is relationships. Why might your life be jacked up in some ways? Maybe you're connected to some of the wrong people. Maybe you haven't had the right boundaries. Maybe you know you hadn't had the right boundaries, but you don't know how to fix it. You don't know what you should have done. You know, oh, well, I shouldn't have done that. That didn't work. Crystal, thanks for ignoring me. Oh, honey, we're not ignoring you. Oh. What, did you ask a question earlier? Comments go by so fast. Put your question down again, honey. I hadn't seen it. Or if you did private message me, your message, especially if you private messaged me in the last 2 days, I've been so busy with the inbox. I have the other box, you know, the one on Facebook called the other box. And you end up with messages in there and you're like, oh my gosh, that was a month ago. Ooh. Yikes. Or that's been 2 or 3 days. It wasn't in there. I looked. Now it is. We don't know why. So, Lord, we just ask you to bless Crystal right now. Crystal, that's a spirit of rejection. So we take authority over that right now. You are not rejected. We take authority over every lie of the devil right now in Jesus' name. Jesus, we ask you to show up in a tangible way for Crystal right now. Crystal is my sissy's name. My real sissy. When am I coming to India? When am I coming to India? That's going to be when I find safe, good connections that are healthy. You know what I'm saying? No one wants to go to a foreign land and not come back. You know what I'm saying? Well, I'm going to jump off. I love you guys. I'll see y'all in the morning for Morning Word. Maybe in the morning, I almost feel like God is going to have some of y'all ask me questions. Maybe we'll do a Q&A in the morning, a question and answer. I know we're in this book of Revelation, but I really feel like in the morning, we're going to do like a question and answer, a Q&A session. Bye, you guys. Love you. See ya.